Today is the feast of Blessed Frederic Ozanam of France. He was born in France in the year 1813 as the fifth child of his parents, who had in all 14 children. Out of them, only three survived, and Frederick is one of the three who reached adulthood. When he grew up, his taste was in literature. But his father, who was a medical doctor, wanted him to specialize in law. He yielded to the desire of his father and went to Paris and specialized in law and got his degree and started teaching in the same university. While he was in the university as a student, he met some of the professors who mocked Christianity, and he had to stand up and defend his faith. And among the fellow students also, many were very critical of Christianity of his time. So he formed a discussion group consisting of all sorts of university students and professors, including Catholic believers, atheists, and some agnostics also. They discussed contemporary issues, and most of them held a firm conviction that Christianity, especially Roman Catholic Christianity, is totally irrelevant for the moment. Once it was relevant, but now it has become irrelevant, especially with the background of French Revolution in Paris. It was a big challenge to Frederick. Frederick, along with one of his friends, started visiting the slums of Paris and helping the poor people at the best he could. He also, to better organize his social work, started a society to make his work among the poor more effective. He founded a charitable organization called the Saint Vincent de Paul Society. They earnestly got involved in the improvement of the poor and the needy. In the meantime, he also earned a doctorate in literature, his first love. He got married to Emily, and they had a daughter, Maria. Due to hard work and lack of rest, his health became poor, and they took a vacation to Italy, and they stayed there for a whole year and returned to Paris. He also started a newspaper called New Era, specializing and focusing on the need of the poor people and supporting the fight for their justice. The Vincent de Paul Society was growing and spread from France to various countries of Europe. They were known for their concern and support for the poor. In the meantime, his health suffered again, and the family went to Italy for his convalescence. He returned to France and got involved in his work, and again his health deteriorated, and this time he died on the 8th of September 1853. Recognizing his hard work, firm commitment, and deep faith, Pope John Paul II beatified him when he visited France. He was beatified in the Cathedral of Paris during his visit. The challenge we have is similar to what Frederick Ozanam faced in his time. The fight between the poor and those who have too much is still going on in the world. And as he, Frederick, chose to get involved for the betterment of the poor. We need to make a choice of love to fight for social justice, which will be a lasting solution for the contemporary society in the world.